It's not hope so. Like we need to enable ourselves for bringing up some more challenges or some more platform to develop a new product. What government is looking forward, what medical team is looking forward, or what the entire nation is looking forward. So it's a time for us to enable ourselves and bringing up a new product like the manufacturing of disinfectant or the sanitizer, the low-cost ventilator, or drone technology, or automatic innovations. So all these technology can be discussed, like we'll be discussing by today. Definitely, I think it's going to be an eye-opening or a good platform. Definitely from this, we will try to carry out a big team, and we will see like how we can able to bring out all this enabled technology and support the government. So each and every one of you is very important, and engineers are the one of the biggest pillar. Now the doctors are being suffered, and they're doing their duties more than 200%. It's our duty that how we can able to prevent this COVID and spreading of that. Also introduce a new instrument or bringing some new technology in order to like give us a big automations for doctors as well as medicinal team. I think this will serve in the emergency situation as well. This can also enable us to bring up in a more entrepreneurship. So once all this technology has been enabled, definitely I think it can enter into the mass production. And this can lead to the biggest entrepreneur for our country, and this will give us like a made in India. That's what the government is looking forward. Definitely, the World Bank yesterday they have estimated that the GDP of our country is going to come around 1.8 to 2.4, and at least to bring out the level of 2.4, we need more kind of a product than made in India. The country has lots of youth, and the average the age group of our India is almost 29 years. I think when this entrepreneurship is coming out, definitely I think people will involve themselves in bringing out so many products, and that will create lots of movement in our country, and that will make the engineering problems also in the solutions more. And we hope so everybody is going to involve in that and join together. Definitely, I think it's only one the voice we have to give it to the government that engineers are there to build our nations, not only during the period of normalized way, when the emergency period of that, definitely I think engineers will contribute in a huge way. So that is what this meeting is going to happen at. And we are so much of thankful to the IEA because the 100 years institutions is supporting in bringing how the engineers can involve in protect ourselves from the COVID-19. So definitely I think IEA entire world can give us lots of support. And also we thank all our partners, that is Tiruvallur chapter of Institute of Engineers, and then National Youth Council, Engineers Without Border, and Green 9. So I think there are enormous organization is going to join with us. It is only one voice, that is how we are going to prevent this COVID-19 from our country. Also how the economic prosperity is going to increase. So I think we have a sufficient time is there till another 15 minutes. I think any of the invitees who have joined here, they can also like give their version of COVID-19. So till the speakers get connected. Okay. Sir, hello.
Hello, Pam.
Working, la.
Yes.
Here. Sir, PS Kumar, connect panna solunga.
PS Kumar, okay, call it.
Thank you, Google. Keep the session live so that people who are joining also they can make it connected so that.
Maybe I think any of the speakers also, like any of the invitees also can talk about this COVID-19 till 10 minutes. They're... Hola, you are there?
Yeah, I'm there. So, on priority, so then who are joined? Rakesh Jha is there, so... sir can introduce himself and give a overview of the
line la varla niye.
Rakesh Jaza, so you can just introduce yourself and can also give your view on this COVID-19 situation.
Rakesh is there.
Okay, so people who are joining, so they can introduce themselves. So like someone admin who has joined, so please you can introduce yourself, ma'am. No, your audio is...
You can connect it to our all other Facebook Live also.
Come, Tanjavur Local Center Chairman Sumadhi Madam.
Okay, so you just make yourself audible, ma'am. So it's not audible. So can you please be louder? No, it's not audible, ma'am. So like your mic is somewhat cranky, I think so. Now it's okay, I think so. No.
It is not audible.
It's not audible, ma'am.
Oh, you have to remove your mute.
No, it's unmuted only. So, like, her volume is, I do not know. Until then, we can have introduction of Narayan Sami, sir, from Madurai Local Center.
Yes, sir. I am Narayan Sami, secretary to the Madurai Local Center.
Great, sir.
Sir, regarding this Madurai, what is called our coronavirus, here we are on the safe side only. Of course, as per Tamil Nadu counting, it was 31. But we are getting our what is called the necessary test items in time also. In the assistant also, we are getting everything over. There's no problem on that one. Even we follow the rules and regulations of the what are the local body is giving the orders that we follow all that. So Madurai is running smooth, sir.
Any other, sir? Speaker Dr. P.S. Kumar joined recently.
Yes, sir. Sir, P.S. Kumar, sir, you can introduce yourself, sir. Actually, the meeting would be starting by 6:30. Before that, Gokul, sir, please connect all the speakers so that...
I'm just talking. I think Amar Prasad Reddy said he'll be connecting 5 minutes.
Okay.
And I'm talking to your Ilanga Rangaswamy. I just know about
status. Fine, sir. So those people who have introduced, they can put themselves in mute mode as well as you can switch off your video, sir, so that the bandwidth can be restricted. Ma'am, yeah. So you can introduce yourself. Your audio is very feeble. Okay, ma'am. So, no. Okay, then. No, there is some glitch in your end, ma'am, so that you can introduce yourself at a later time. So, sorry for the trouble, actually. So, in between, P.S. Kumar, sir, is there. So, sir, you can take your introduction, sir. So, you can just go ahead and introduce yourself, the speaker of the session, P.S. Kumar, sir.
Good evening, friends. This is Dr. P.S. Kumar. So I'm an active member in IEA, and I have, along with two of my partners, we have a company called ETA Smart. We are into manufacturing of central commercial air conditioning systems. Okay, I'm also a founder of 360-degree transformation, which is more into transformation of businesses in the challenging situations. So today I'm going to talk on role of engineers in current situation, how to scale up the production to meet the demand, and how the engineers need to respond.
Sir?
Anyway, see you sir. Guys again.
You connect on now, sir. Yes, sir.
Kumar sir.
Yes, please.
Yes, sir. You can go ahead and introduce yourself, sir.
Yo, I introduced myself already.
Okay, then. Thank you so much, sir. So, in between, someone was about to join. So, if other speakers also, you can put your video so that you can be at the top layer, sir. So that you can be in the session, sir. So, that's what.
Balamurana, who is MAKDEM?
Is Magdul Jamam is Magdum is my friend who was with LNT or with
LNT. Line la na idu kuduthundane SMS line la vaanga appadiye va.
Magdum.
Magdum, please introduce yourself, sir. You are open, sir. Magdum, sir. You can just introduce yourself, sir.
Magdum is from Bombay and Rakesh Jai is from Delhi. Arun Prakash, all are my friends. Our ex-colleague and Nandakumar is also a managing director of Whitman Robotics. All are ex-colleagues of me from L&T.
Great, sir.
So I invited them to join. Many more likely to join also.
Great, sir. So, I have given a general instruction, sir. So, the session would be starting sharply by 6:30 and ending by 7:30, probably. So, in case of any QA, that would be dealt after 7:30. Those people online, they can rise up for the occasion only by 7:30, sir. That is the general instruction, sir, that is being circulated. So, in case of... sorry, sir. It's again echoing, I think so. Okay. So, in case of any query, please adhere to the rules so that the session would be completed and then we can have the QA, sir. Thank you for your cooperation.
Hala, can you send one invite to my mail ID?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
Okay.
Balaji, your voice is not audible.
No, I didn't speak at all. So, actually, I'm on mute only, Gokul. So, you just drive the session. You just drive the session so that it would be okay for me to put on mute.
No, you can increase the volume.
Gokul, all other speakers also joined.
Hey, Gokul, increase
on the way. They're going to join now.
Okay, so you just take a mic, Gokul, so that it would be useful for us to, because you are going to handle the session, your volume should be very high.
That's what, some voice is very low, suddenly.
No, everyone is okay with the volume. Your volume is also okay. Just go ahead and give an introduction so that...
Gulanaja sir is coming. Sir, Randa sir.
Already gave the invitation, but they have some this thing. That's why Bala, I will send invite.
No, yes, sir. So I'm just moving. You are also co-host, sir. I have already made you as the co-host. So you can just send the invitation, sir. You can take the session also, sir.
No, I don't have the rights.
No. Now it's okay, sir. Now you are the co-host. You can just take over, sir.
The invite screen and all, I don't have the invite screen.
Oh, okay. Now, Gokul, you just take over the session. Yeah. So until then, I'll go.
Okay. Bala, it's okay. And I'll manage it.
Magdum, your audio was not proper. Magdum, you need to unmute to talk.
சார், இப்போ உங்க மெயில் ஐடிக்கு ஒரு இன்விடேஷன் அனுப்பிச்சிருக்கேன் பாருங்க.
Gokul, please proceed with the session.
Sir, unga video on pannunga sir, Gunaraja sir.
Shall we start, sir? Gunaraja sir is going to join or?
I think he's joined. He's OnePlus 7 Pro is, I think, is this thing, but the video is not coming.
Okay. Maybe Amar Prasad already also said, he said something problem.
Sir, mute.
I'm telling you.
இமிடியட் பாஸ்ட் பிரசன்ட் சார் கைண்ட்லி இன்ட்ரோடியூஸ் சார்.
சார், யுவர் ஆடியோ இஸ் நாட் தேர் சார். ப்ளீஸ் எனேபிள் யுவர் ஆடியோ சார். சார் குணராஜா சார், யுவர் ஆடிபிள் your audio has some trouble sir, so sir, we could not hear you sir, could you please be louder sir?
No audio. Vice President, our President, Past President, no audio.
Yes, sir, so. Hello? Gokul?
Balaji, just sir, call to Illuma.
Sheikh Daud, sir, right now he has joined the session. So, Daud, sir, can you introduce yourself, sir?
Video is on, audio is on. சார் அதுல வரலையா உங்க உங்க இது வரலையா கேட்கலையா ஆடியோ எனக்கு பேனல்ல பாக்குறேன் உங்க வீடியோ
Sir, you can unmute yourself so that comes out, sir. You can mute.
Kekuda? Okay, okay, okay.
How you take it?
Huh? Kekuda? Kekuda? Epa, the one button, pa?
Bala.
Padmini?
Bala?
Ah, yeah, yeah, yes, yes, Gokul.
Just talk to Ilango, sir. He said some connection problem. Arthritis problem is coming.
Okay. Oh, okay, okay. So I'll just talk to him. So in the meantime, you can just handle the session, Gokul.
Sir, I think, so Daud, sir, you can just introduce yourself and then we can start the session.
Who, myself, huh?
Yes, sir.
So you want me to start?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Good evening, all of you. I'm Dr. G.M. Gunaraja, immediate past president, the Institution of Engineers India, also the vice president of World Federation of Engineering Organization. I'm happy to join this meeting organized by the Institution of Engineers India, Tiruvallur Center. And the Institution of Engineers, Tamil Nadu State Center, regarding the responsibilities of engineers during this COVID-19. We know the engineering and the engineers are playing a major role in the societal engineering and everyday life of the human. Even during this COVID-19, we are happy to note that all our engineers are working towards fighting against COVID-19. Mainly, the maintaining of essential services, in terms of maintaining stability of power grid during lights out on 5th April, maintenance of support for the biomedical equipment, creating prefabricated hospitals, small facilities, process industries, particularly the innovation of ventilators, Mahindra and Mahindra and others who have been started working 24/7, particularly to help this COVID-19. I'm happy that this Zoom meeting being organized to bring out the experts to bring their expertise, what we have to do to fight against the COVID-19 and how we can support this society. We are very happy. Our President, Prime Minister Modi ji is taking all the effort and all our state governments also supporting to bring down the COVID-19 effects. I am very much pleased to thank all the speakers today who have been joining for this program, particularly the focus of the engineers for the recovery of MSMEs, most important. Also, we had to be ready and plan for strategic investment from Japan and others who have been moving facilities from China for the manufacturing. Greater reliance on digital technologies, work from home, processing, particularly our Institution of Engineers India, of increasing the membership and other digital platforms. I am very happy once again to inaugurate this session and congratulate all the speakers, congratulate the Chairman Secretary of Tamil Nadu State Center and the Tiruvallur Local Center for initiating this program. Thank you.
Sir, thank you so much for your inaugural of this first meet.
Definitely, I think we are so happy that we have got a good amount of support from IEI, Institute of Engineers, who readily accepted to organize such a meet in Zoom. I think this is one of the initiations what we are going to do, and this is going to be a role of engineers, how we are going to prevent this COVID-19. Definitely, I think more than 21 days we have been locked down. We are all sitting in the home. I think doctors and other like police people, everybody is working like 24 hours. Definitely, it's a time that our engineers can also support them in various aspects of technology building, as well as in prevention of this COVID, and moreover, like how we can able to enable them in morality. So I think we have four wonderful speakers today. So including our Dr. T.M. Gunaraja, who is also a mechanical engineer and past president of our IEA India. And to say about like he's an 100 years the IEA contributed president. So the IEA prouds that his contributions, as well he also having his vice president in the World Engineering Federation organization. So definitely I think he's watching globally how this COVID-19 is getting prevented from across the nation, across the globe. And we will also get his support in framing up furthermore projects after this discussion. So we have one speaker, Dr. Amar Prasad Reddy, who is a computer science engineer, and he is an advisor to Honorable Union Minister for State for Health and Family Welfare. So currently the health and family welfare is working tirelessly for our nation, because ours is the one of the nations where the number two in the population, 138 million peoples are there. Definitely government is ensured every populations, every life is important in our country. So I think he is there. And we have APMJ Sheikh Dawood, who is a grandson of our Abdul Kalam, and also is the trustee of Abdul Kalam International Foundation. He is also a computer engineer. And we have P.S. Kumar, Dr. P.S. Kumar, who is a mechanical engineer and managing director of ETS Smart Private Limited. He was in various fields of L&T, as well as in various corporate. And he's a well-known person like in 360 degree technology. So I think one more speaker is going to join. I think Mr. C. Ilamu Rangaswamy, chemical engineer, also a social entrepreneur, been engaging the innovations and inventions in the Tamil Nadu. And he's a role model in creating a model village in Kuthambakkam, which is almost like near to Chennai. So definitely, I think four speakers is going to give lots of information. I think each speakers, like they can initiate with 5 minutes. We have a 15-minute session for speakers. So we will start with each speakers with the 5 minutes of a session. First, Dr. AMR, that is shortly called Amar Prasad Reddy. So who is in the line? So can you hear us, sir?
Yes, sir. I can hear you.
Yes, sir. Okay. I think you know that COVID-19, the name itself, like throughout the world, I think almost 750 million people are, I think in a day at least, they will be talking about coronavirus. So the name has become so fascinating. And I think it has become a threat to the world, not only in India. And moreover, like I think the world is watching around India also, how India is going to protect. So as you are from Government of India and you are an advisory for Minister of Health and Family Welfare. So how does you think about the engineers are going to contribute for this COVID-19, what government is taking up precautions, and how they are enabling India engineers also in their support?
Hi, good evening. You guys can hear me? Hello?
Yes, sir. We can hear.
Yeah, okay. That's great. Hope I can see Mr. Ramadas Ji is there, and your president is there, IAC president is there, and my friend Sheikh Dawood Ji is there. Vocal, yes, I can hear you. It's nice that you have taken such a wonderful initiative that you can connect all of us in this crisis. Basically, I think now the problem, we all know what is the problem. The problem is that it's not about the virus. It's about the life-saving equipments, test kits, masks, and vaccine. So these are all the things which depends mostly on engineers. So without engineers, I think nothing is possible. Even to create a ventilator, it's not in a healthcare worker's job. It is a job of engineer. So we play a very vital role. But unfortunately, what's happening, this entire the world is depending on one country called China. I think we have to bluntly accept this. At this crisis, we need test kits from them. We need ventilators from them. We need N95 masks from them. We need, you know, even I'm sure that they are going to help in many ways. But see, we are depending completely on them. I think this is not a fair business. I think we have to engage our entrepreneurs. That's very important. And we have to create a lot of scope for SMEs, means small, medium enterprises. And we have to activate and we have to create an environment. You know, in India, most of
engineering students, most of the engineering students, the problem is very simple. They're workaholic, they want to work somewhere. Their innovation skills being dumped into some company. And even though they are capable of doing many things, unfortunately, our Indians, the mindset is something different. And I think this has set a trend that you see how we are facing problem. Even for N95 masks, we have to break the chain. Ventilators, and yesterday it was told that in an open press meet by Tamil Nadu Health Secretary that we're supposed to get some COVID kits, but unfortunately it has been moved to USA. But I think all these things happening because the priority plays the role for each and every country. And in this aspect, I think IEC has taken a wonderful initiative to create a platform where engineers can engage themselves, they can create, and they can do an interdependent model where we all can work together. First thing is very important is the mindset of our engineers, which need to be set, and we have to create a very strong environment for entrepreneurship and innovation hubs. Like that, I think we have to create this model. IEC has a lot of presence. I think you have presence across the country. Even I can say across the district, and even you have your presence in rural colleges also. I think we have to create a task force. That is very important. Very important. Task force is very important. So my entire agenda here is to create a task force. And you know that the war is between virus and earth. And who is going to save the earth? Obviously, we are all with the six senses. We are going to save the earth. So to save the earth, I think engineer plays a vital role. Okay, so I leave it here. I think we have to create a task force with innovators, with scientists, with industrialists, with angel investors, investors. I think we have to create a very coherent model. So this is what I put here.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir. I think you have been initiated. Yes, sir. So, yeah.
Move on our villa.
Can you hear me, Gokul?
Yes, sir. We can hear you, sir. We can hear you. You can continue, sir.
Hello, can you hear?
Yeah, we can hear you, sir. No, we are hearing you. I think you can remove your mute. You can remove your mute and you can talk, I think.
Hello?
Yeah, I think... sir, AMR sir, you can remove your mute. Now you can talk.
Gokul, your voice is very low.
So you can talk now? You can hear now? Yeah, sir, you can hear now.
Yeah, it's very low, but yes, I can hear you. It's very low.
Yeah, you can continue, sir. Your voice is loud.
Yeah, I have done. I think I have already conveyed that, no? The task force need to be created and we need to...
Gokul, he finished speak and then you... Gokul.
Yes, sir.
Ask him to next speaker to start the session.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Dr. AMR, I think what you said is right. So that is what we thought, like how the task force of engineers group can be enabled.
So I think we have now our APJ MJ Sheikh Daud, who's a grandson of Abdul Kalam sir. I think the nation is like has waited more for this 2020. So what he said almost like 20 years before, I think now the total world is renovating themselves, and he's India also in that. So definitely, I think now I think Daud sir can say about how this COVID-19 can be like used as a tool. How the dreams of Abdul Kalam sir can be taken up into the measure.
Okay. Good evening, everybody. So I'm happy to join this session. I'm really happy to participate in Institution of Engineers and organizing this event as we go through one of the not just a pandemic event happening, COVID-19. So let me start with this. So let everybody think about, let me remove the pain of the patients. What Dr. Kalam always says. Even whenever he talks to a doctor or nurse or healthcare worker, he tell them that you think about this, you remove the pain of the patient. So now we all got a very big challenge ahead of us, and still we are going through that. Let me emphasize a couple of points what I think we should be doing it. So as engineers, there are a couple of ways we think problems and solve it. Two things happening in the world. One is invention. So invention is something we actually invent something which is not existing and come up with a completely new idea and that propose it. Something is called, another one is called innovation. So innovation is combining of different strategies and technologies and provide solution to any problem. So I'm talking about, I would like to talk about more about this, innovation, how we can bring a lot of services together and bring solution. So engineers got a unique idea about taking any problem and providing solution. So here we've got a very unique situation in our universe. We never experienced with such advanced technology we have got, but still we are struggling to address this issue. Because this is something this virus we are not hear about it, or we are not familiar about it. The entire medical history never thought about this. This is how it's going to go. So as a human, any human go through this kind of challenge, we have got two responses. One, how you respond to that such an event. Another one, what is the solution you can find? Response and solution finding. This is the two aspects we should focus on. The response is this. So my request is, I keep doing it, and I request all of you to do this. The awareness should be spread even more, it's required. We should not think that we are safe or not. The awareness should be much more cleaner, and all people of India should know that this is still, we are in a danger, and people should keep in hope. First, they should lock down the home. That is the first thing they should know, because I have seen a lot of people are they're not taking it serious thing, because first we should save our life, then only we can come out and start giving the solution. The second one, we are talking about lacking of facilities. Like equipments, ventilators, medicines, maybe other stuff. But we are not lack of resources. We have resources. Only thing is, how do we organize this? How do you coordinate each and everybody and come up with the solutions? But what I am seeing is a lot of positive, including government. Our Prime Minister is very much, he stood on the ground saying that, he was supporting. Prime Minister is the one guy who is supporting all the initiative, whoever comes forward giving the solution to this problem. And really, I respect that. But apart from that, the political view also should come together, and they, everybody start giving the solution. The second one is the engineer's way. I am sure in India is called engineer's heaven. That is what is the world is calling us. But India is called engineer's heaven, then we should have a solution for that. So each city, each village, at least one engineer is there. So slowly they can talk about the precautions and other, what are the equipments needed thing, you can do it in a small way. That will help to contain this issue in a larger space. If one engineer start contributing in a village, whatever, irrespective of spreading the awareness or spreading the cleanliness, whatever it is, and come up with a small equipment, and all these things definitely will help in the larger scale to tackle this issue. The second thing is, if you look at the world, India has got a youngest population. India's have a very, very youngest population. They can tackle any issue. That is what Dr. Kalam believed. India has got a very unique ability to tackle any issues because our generation, because we've got a lot of young minds who can work on that. See, if you remember, we are denied a lot of technologies by countries. A lot of technologies like atomic technology is denied, rocket science is denied, a lot of things denied by world countries. But India himself, India is started inventing all these things, started collaborating with innovations, so we have come up with ideas. So I'm sure that the innovations, the bringing minds together, and definitely will break all these barriers and come up with nice technologies, innovators. Now all these healthcare things and all, everything is called technologies. Even though it's a medicine, everything is called technology. We need a lot of experimentation and we can actually take using the artificial intelligence, machine learning. We can combine, we have a lot of data sampling. Based on that, we can come up with different approaches. That is also is welcome. So I believe to start with bringing all the minds together and work with the team. Thank you.
Gokul, inga session edhu avaru mudichitar paar nee ipo idu panna arthu kumar ku introduction kudutha idu panna.
Yes sir. Thank you so much for our I think he has given a wonderful idea. I think the more important is awareness. I think most of the people of our country also reach the awareness, but still it is required. And what he said was every engineer should come out for this COVID-19 to fight.
Yeah.
So definitely, I think from here, I think we can able to take, as already Dr. Amar also said, we need to form a task force. Can you hear?
Yeah, we can hear you. Yes, I can hear you.
Sir. Yeah. So, yeah, that's what, as our Dr. Amar already said, the task force team has to be formed. So definitely this for task force team, every engineers of every house, they can also be inside that. And we can able to bring about a lot of change in our country. And the COVID-19 is going to be there for 3 months or 6 months. After that, we need to increase our economic prosperity of our country. That is
just
a challenge.
Audio.
So, I would like to invite our Dr. P.S. Kumar. I think he's the person who can able to scale up the done so many scale up of the can we invite our Dr. P.S. Kumar, who is a mechanical engineer as well as like he holds a big position in L&T and currently is an MD of ETS Smart Private Limited.
Thank you, Gogal. Good evening, friends. Thank you for the opportunity given to talk on engineer's role on current situation. Bala, can you please mute all the people?
Sure, sir. Yes.
And thank you. See, if you see COVID-19 situations, and many of us, we think that it is an enormous problem comes to us. For me, it gives a lot of opportunities to all divisions of engineering. If you take mechanical, electrical, electronics, civil engineering, robotics, electronics and instrumentation, chemical engineering, everywhere, it throws a lot of challenge for all of us. As Dr. Gunaraja has already told, and Mr. Sheikh Dawood also told, Mr. Amar Prasad already also told the same thing, we need not invent something, we need to innovate. That means we need to add up our resources and come up with quickly with the solutions for different problems we are facing it.
Sir,
you have to mute off also.
You have to mute yourself, sir.
So, whenever
sir,
we come
across... Sir, I need... mute panirken, unmute putra, sir.
Okay. Bala. Can I start, Bala? Yeah. Whenever we come across a problem like this, most of us react to the problem. We must understand reaction may not solve the problem fully and only our response may solve the problem. When we react, mostly our decisions are based on feelings and emotions. But when we respond, mostly our decisions are based on facts and logical thinking. most of the engineers employed, some of us are self-employed, and we have our own factories also. So to solve this problem, everyone can contribute in our own ways. I'm coming with the responding to the situation of COVID-19. I have some good news and I have bad news. As Dr. Gunaraja told already, the good news is many people, already Japan has announced they want to move out of China. Either $2.2 billion they are investing and supporting their suppliers to move out of China from manufacturing or sourcing itself. So it throws a tremendous opportunity for all of us to capture that market. The bad news is, like us, other competent Indian people, other than the Indians, we have Indonesians, we have Thailand, Philippines, Vietnam, all are potential competitor to us. Those people also try to grab the business from those countries, especially from USA, Japan, and Europe. So that is the bad news. So we need to be innovative and work smart and then come out with a solution which is cost economical and beneficial to the persons. Okay. If we transform ourselves to be more efficient and effective people, then we can meet the stringent quality standards, learn and apply, follow international manufacturing systems. You take example of medical PPE or ventilators. Ventilators, are every one of us knows about, there are two types of ventilators. One is invasive and non-invasive. A non-invasive is only supplying oxygen to the mask level. Whereas invasive is going into the human body and supplies the required amount of oxygen at the required rate and taking out the carbon dioxide coming out of the lungs. It basically does the job of a lungs itself. So the production of ventilator is not so critical. Testing the ventilator, making it available for the entire world. Normally, ventilators are tested for at least 18 to 24 months before put into the production. So, hello, call got cut. Hello.
No, we can hear you. We can hear you.
Okay. Only one person is there in the things. Yeah, everyone is there. Okay. So what happens is this 18 to 24 months is testing. If you take a ventilator, I just did a small research on this ventilator. Mostly it contains around 30 to 40% is only a electronics items. Balance 30 to 40% is only a plastic injection molded product. Injection molded product, currently you can, for urgent requirement, you can make it out of 3D printing. It is called additive manufacturing. We can be produced. But before going into that subject, do we need ventilators? Because if you look out the history, whoever is going to the, like, you know, like what current Indian government is doing is the best method according to the international experts. Because ventilators, if you say it, if 100 people need ventilators and if they are given with ventilators, only 33 people may come alive. 66 people may pass away. In that situation, the best way is prevention is better than trying to have ventilators and supporting them. So more important is, like, you know, you have seen recently, even some of the doctors at Mumbai got infected. So the PPE is more important than the ventilator. PPE is the personal protective equipment, which is nothing but a mask and coating and what you call, you have a different protective layers. There are different technologies are available across the globe. Barrier technologies are, it's a laminated sheets. It's a simple process for the other people. Many extruders are available throughout the country and this can be produced very fast also. It is not so difficult. So stitching facilities also, we are the stitcher. And we stitches and supplies a lot of garments and other things throughout the world. So producing PPE is also not very difficult one. So it gives an enormous opportunity for both ways, producing the things. Some of people are working on it already. Some of my friends are working on creating a nano coating on the PPE. Nano coating is a coating, it is antiviral coating, which can, so that the PPE can be reused. Initial stages, let us not work out for reusable PPE, that is a personal protective equipment. Let us go for the disposable things and later we can come into the nano coating type of things because that needs to be tested and all. Coming to the mask, as correctly told by Dr. Gunaraja, we were over dependent on China. Just because they were supplying it very cost economical, we were never bothered to produce an ourselves. But now, when the situation comes up, we can meet up the demand and we can supply the product at any fastest pace also. Definitely, the government of India, government of Tamil Nadu might have worked already and might have created enormous resources, arranged the things and all. And I'm coming to one more point, like Dr. Amar Prasad Reddy was telling about sanitizers and your, alcohol-based hand sanitizers type of things. There is, as per WHO standard, there is no need to go for only alcohol-based sanitizers. You can go with hypochlorite with 500 ppm also. So there is technology available and we already started offering it. And the payback period is not even 1 year, 1 month. So there is what we can do is we can give you a concentrated hypochlorite, which is 5000 ppm, which can be used, diluted and can be used for sanitification purpose. The cost of the material or the cost of the end product will be less than 100 rupees per kg, per liter. So, which can be used effectively for the things. In the sanitation, what happens is basically you are killing the bacteria or you are killing the virus, which is not getting infected into the body. So, either 70% alcohol, if you have it, it will ensure that the outer layer, what you call it's a protein layer of the virus will get destroyed. So it will lose its properties. Whereas if you take with the 500 ppm hypochlorite, it also does the same job. If you refer the WHO standard, which was released on 19th March 2020, WHO is recommending to go with either alcohol based or with the hypochlorite. So the hypochlorite is nothing but an electrical invention, which was done for something else, for purification of water. Now we can use this, like what Amar Prasad Reddy has told, or Mr. Sheikh Dawood told, we innovate that idea and used it for this application. Here we use the same electrolyte and we are converting the electrolysis process to make and produce concentrated hypochlorite with the help of titanium dioxide anode and cathodes. Like initially, it may be initial investment. The problem with that thing is the volume will be cannot be less than 2,000 liters per day.
Sundar, avunga picture la nama picture var matenga adha
Kannan sir. Yeah. So what I suggest is we need not worry about this. As told by people earlier, the task force needs to be formed. Maybe IEA can give a recommendation to the people. Experts are available. As told by our host, Mr. Balamurgan, we must understand, accept the fact that it will take minimum 3 to 9 months, depending upon the situation. We need to come across this 3 to 9 months. We need to gear up for our manufacturing facility. We need to gear up with work from home culture. So many things we may have to prepare ourselves. But there's an opportunity for us to equip ourselves, enhance ourselves, improve our skills and knowledge on different things, and try to help and make the things better. So we need not worry about that. And only thing I would like to suggest is we must work smart, optimize the positive impact and minimize the negative impact. We must form two core groups in each company. One group can work on minimizing the negative impact and other group should work on optimizing the positive impact. If we have our own plant, then the managing director or the owner of the company should spend at least 40% of his time in trying to identifying the handling the situation after 2 years, and the balance 60% of time he can spend on working on the current scenario, handling scenario. So this right now I am ending up my talk and I will be back again.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dr. P.S. Kumar. Can we ask our Ilongo sir is on the line? Balamurgan?
Yes, sir. Tell me, sir.
Can you talk to Ilongo sir? I think his audio is in problem.
Yes, sir. So, I could directly connect
him right now, or like we can ask our L&T, the head has come, Kaliraj, and we can ask him to talk to him.
Okay, so I will just catch up, sir, with my own personal ID, sir. Until then, Kaliraj, sir, can go ahead and talk, sir.
Sir, I think we invite two people. I think one of our Dr. Ranganath, sir, is there, who is the past chairman of IEA Tamil Nadu State Center, and as well as he's a council member. So we invite him for this. Meet also. So Ranganath sir is there. And our Kalirajan sir. Can we see Kalirajan sir, who is from L&T?
Yeah. I'm available.
Are you able to? So we are not audible, sir. I think.
Now, are you able to hear me? Hello.
Yeah. Yes, sir. You can introduce yourself and you can share your views.
Are you able to hear me now?
Yeah. We can hear you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Good evening, all my friends. This is Dr. Rajan.
Some feedback. Somebody is having a mobile phone on as well as the desktop.
Okay. Is it fine? Okay. So I'm Dr. Kalirajan. I'm heading special initiatives in L&T construction, having almost 32 years of construction experience, and mainly into nuclear industry, all 32 years in nuclear industry. Well, today, this particular gathering, it's the right time that, you know, we are meeting and discussing on the right subject. In the sense, COVID-19 is posing a lot of challenges, and all these challenges are projecting a lot of opportunities for engineers. So a lot of challenges have been already projected by various speakers till now. So I'm not getting into the medical part of the challenges, but there is a huge challenge posed by the global economy, which is going to be, you know, really harden our life, at least for the next one to two years time. The people are expecting that the economy may come back to normalcy only after one and a half years from now. So this particular situation in the global situation is going to pose a biggest challenge for all the engineering fraternity. We are, most of us are into manufacturing, most of us are into technology area. Recently, I have been attending one Harvard business lecture on the economy and how it is going to affect. And they were showing how China has developed till now. And we are way far with respect to embracing the technology, latest technologies compared to China. As far as India is concerned, we are only following Western culture and Western technology, and we just adopt it and then follow it. Whereas China is, they're not even using Google browser, or they're not using WhatsApp, they're not using Facebook. They have developed their own technology. And we are talking about artificial intelligence and machine learning now. Our students, our children are learning now. Whereas China has already adopted and then, you know, exploited the technology to a greater extent. And that is one of the ways in which they could control the COVID-19, you know, in China. But we are much, much far away. So the opportunity for us, in my opinion here, is how we can take the business further. And when Westerners are, you know, going away from China, recently you've seen that, you know, Japan has taken over, passed on an instruction to all their companies to come out of China. And there are hundreds of US companies have already moved out of China. But there is a fear psychosis all over the world. Even today, if you see in HDFC share stock market, if you see even the HDFC bank in India, almost huge amount of shares have been recently purchased by Chinese bank. So China is expanding its hands everywhere, even into India. So when you are going to increase the share market value, share in a particular company beyond certain limit, and China can have a say in that company's growth in that particular company. And lot of, you know, companies in Europe is now going down because of this COVID-19, and China is ready to buy those companies. So as an Indian company, we are not interested in probably in buying and running the foreign companies in their foreign soil. But at the same time, we should not miss the opportunity when it comes to India. When the orders are coming, I recently, you know, last week, about 10 days back, I was addressing, there is one small forum called Tamil Nadu Vanigar Forum. They are, you know, meeting once in a week and then discussing Tamil people should give business only to Tamil people, like that. So in that forum, when I was discussing on the same issue, after my, you know, talk, one of the gentlemen, he shared a view that, you know, already we started getting inquiries from Europe for manufacturing certain things which are manufactured in China. But unfortunately, even today in India, we are not able to match the price of what China is able to supply. So because of the price constraint, the European vendors are again forced to go back to Chinese rather than coming to India. So we need to work on how do we increase our productivity and reduce the cost. That is the most important thing. I think as an engineer, we should concentrate, leave apart coming out of the COVID-19 medically, there are agencies government is working on. But as an industry, as an engineering fraternity, I think we should formulate a group in IEI to work on how do we, you know, improve upon the productivity and make the products more economical and reduce the cost. If we are not going to be, you know, competitive, there are markets in Vietnam, there are markets in, you know, Philippines, Malaysia, Thailand. They will just, you know, take away every business from us. And Indian mindset today is, you know, our productivity ratio, our productivity norms are very, 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 very lenient. And I know personally, when I, you know, put my local people on the job, even without knowing the importance of the job, if it is 5 o'clock, they will just close it and then go away. If we need to be competitive in the market, we cannot do that. Probably a lot of work has to be done in changing the mindset of the Indian people. And I request, you know, IEA to look into this aspect of the industry. How do we increase the productivity and make our products more economical and competitive in the global market? Then only the make in India or getting more business into India is possible and feasible. Otherwise, we can keep on talking all these things. Other countries like Vietnam will take away all the business and we will just keep watching them. So this is my small note. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. I think I don't want to repeat all other people who have talked on the same topic. So I just wanted to say this one particular issue and then close my talk. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. I think you have said about so many things like what India currently required. Definitely, I think through IEA, we can able to take it to the government, able to see. Round we have made it. I think now ask our Gunaratha from four speakers. I think certainly few points I think you can address to all community. Then we can get inside the next session with the speakers. Sir, Gunaratha sir is there. Sir, you can. Yes, sir.
Okay, are you able to hear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Yeah, yeah, it is very nice to hear from the Amar Prasad Reddy, Saikud, and other speakers. And I would also like to put a point here. The World Federation of Engineering Organization, which represents around 100 countries, is already started discussing this topic and the involvement of engineering, the focus of engineering beyond the COVID-19. So all these points which have been very valid, and we should also, the India has to play a major role, being we are the maximum producers of engineers, the young engineers to the global level, where we have to focus and concentrate our development to meet out the requirement of global requirement. This one, and we are also the WFEO, World Federation of Engineering Organization, which is a part of UNESCO, is planning to organize a a Zoom meeting as well as after this crisis is over, an international conference on this. Maybe that may also bring out some fruitful decision and discussion in that meeting, which may be useful for all our engineers. Let us focus and concentrate and for the development of the country and also to help the society. Particularly now the need of the hour is every social person has to be helped by others. So engineers has to play a major role from the smaller level, even to the higher level of artificial intelligence, the machine engineering and thing. But we have to play a major role. This is my point. Thank you. It's a very valid point. We should be able to hear from all the speakers. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir. I think now shortly, I think every speaker can give the 5 minutes challenge and the task. What do you want to throw it to our young engineers? I think if you try to see in the Tamil Nadu itself, we have more than almost 20% of the population may be an engineer. Otherwise, 10% of the population. So what is the ignition point we are going to give it to them and how these people can enable themselves coming inside this or the increase the productivity or what kind of a platform we can give it up? Can we start from Dr. Ramaprasad Reddy?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Okay. It was a really wonderful interaction. I think more such interactions should happen in the following days. And I think we should also adapt of such technological meetings. I think the world has put everyone into this kind of virtual meetings. Anyway, that's good. But I think as an engineer, everyone should work for a sustainable development. That's very important. That is what is missing. I think the entire world is now, the nature is enjoying the human calmness. I think we are all sitting in home, but the nature is enjoying all the damage what we have done to the world. At the same time, I know as an engineer, one should able to think the future. That is very important, especially Indian the engineers who pursue engineer and our universities, Indian universities. I think even the syllabus should be more like. They should trigger, the syllabus should trigger the youngsters' thought process. I think presently that is not happening. You are an engineer, I am an engineer, I think we're all engineers. But it's not happening, that is the missing factor. So we should be able to create an environment where, I have insisted to create a task force. A task force should be categorized. So everyone cannot be work in the same task. So everyone, I may have some interest and you may have some interest. So we should be able to create a task force for emergency disaster management. And we should be able to create a task force for health and other things like that, science and technology. Task force focusing each and every domain. And especially we have 3,000, 4,000 engineering colleges and more than 4,000 polytechnic colleges. 1,000 management institutes. I don't know, but still I think we are engaging engineers as an employee. I think that we need to change that mindset. We should create an environment where one can think beyond the syllabus. One can think beyond their curriculum. I think engineers should work for the future, not for the syllabus should be more interactive. That is very important. Even colleges should adapt the new upgrading technology. I think still people are talking about something which is irrelevant. That's why even engineers struggle after getting the degree from their college. You see most of the engineers, they don't get job. That is the problem. So I think we have to fix as a Institute of Engineers. I think you have a wide presence across the country. And as an advisor to the health minister, Government of India, I am requesting officially that we should create an environment and we should create a task force which can able to provide instant solutions even for the government. It's very, very tough to reach a segment of people. For example, the government want to reach engineering students or engineering industrialists, somebody like that. There is no platform. I think we have to create such platform. Then there is a requirement. probably the Prime Minister can request engineers to jump in and do the surveys. And of course, we are depending too much on China and other countries. I think we have to take a decision and we have to move forward that India should be self-sustainable. That's very important. We are educating, we are giving freebies, we are doing a lot of things, but at the same time, we have to make our people to work for our nation. That's very important. All these days, we are like providing service to the other countries. We are doing all the service work. I think we have to get into the product development. That is very important. Hope my friend Sheikh Dawood brother also will accept my prayer. I think we have to more engage into product development instead of doing service to some other country, some other. I think we have to change our mindset. With this, thank you very much. And my obligation is just straightly to create a task force with all experts and young brains. This is the need of the hour.
How NYC can be involved, sir? National Youth Council.
Yes, I think we can partner. We can partner with NYC. NYC is basically is working a lot of good things in the society. We are widely present. We have widely covered almost South India. I think we can work jointly in bringing some. And I think we have to create some innovation hubs. For that, I can help you. So we have a lot of industrialists. We can provide innovation hubs. For example, I can speak to our this Marg. I think this Swarnabhumi, which is special economic zone. No? We can create some innovation hub. What Gokul? I think Gokul will accept that.
Yes, sir. Definitely.
So we have to create a lot of innovation hub. We have to create that environment, right? That environment is totally missing. The kind of environment where ideas can flow, and we have to create that platform. There is the platform is now basically we are all speaking that there should be a bridge between colleges and the corporates and government. But frankly, I'm telling, where is the bridge? The bridge is missing. We are building the bridge for so many years. I think we have to create the platform. That is very important. I think this is a wonderful meeting and nice to see all my friends here, especially my brother Dawood and Ramdasji and the president of IEC. Nice. I think we should come out. Even after this meeting, I think you should be able to come out with
the outcome. What we have discussed, we need to be published. They have to get into the documentation. That is the strength of the foreign countries. Whatever they do, they record and they publish it. That is the strength. We all know,
definitely.
We all know that. Now the Ayurveda, the Ayush, the Ministry of Ayush is strongly insisting you have to take golden milk. What is golden milk? Have you heard this term? Very simple, turmeric milk. See, the name has been changed. Now they call it as a golden milk. This is nothing but a turmeric milk. You add turmeric in milk and do pepper and some jaggery, means not chakra. We call it as a country sugar. So you add it and you drink it every day. It's good for your health. They say it. And they identified it. And turmeric, it is our property. I think we have to spread our culture and tradition also. That's very important. Basically, let me tell you, my dear friends, this body is not made for always to eat. This body is for something else. We have to create a sustainable world. We have to create a more a positive world. And if you can see that a lot of negativity is going in and around. But let me tell you, the government, the Honorable Prime Minister of India, since I'm closely working with the government, I'm telling you, working 24/7, especially the officers in health ministry, like they are like how can I say that? No, it's like launching a rocket, and how you feel in last 10 seconds. That is a feel for 24/7 for us. So we are working day and night, and PPE, yes, I think a lot of manufacturers are there. We are procuring a lot of PPEs, and somebody has told that there is some nanotechnology they are bringing out so that it can be reused. I think if possible, can you share the document to me? I think we can work it out. PPEs is very important, and VTM kits, that is also this viral transport medium, that is also very important.
Yes,
the problem now actually we are facing, it's not about the resources. We have the resource, we have the company, we have the technology. It is about the raw material. So the base material we are depending on China. We are depending on so many other countries. We don't have the base material. We have the technology, we have the mission, we have the people to work, we have everything, but raw material is missing. So I think we have to revive the entire policy.
What you said rightly, definitely, I think
thoughts.
We will make it up as a document and we will try to make it up. Can we ask our Sheikh Dawood to give us like what is like now challenging as a challenge, so what we want to throw to the engineers if they want to do something for COVID-19?
Okay, thank you, Google. As Chairman Dawood our friend said, okay, it's a lot of, this is a mission mode. We should take it as a mission mode. It is not only now, okay, it's not about COVID-19. I see a very sad situation about our current education system and the industry connect, whatever we try to do. Rightly, our friend Ramakrishna said, there is a bridge. So the bridge is this. We are producing lakhs and lakhs of engineers every year. I don't know for whom to prove that. Producing engineers is not our job, okay? Producing people who can contribute for, you know, for a sustainable society. So that team is not going anywhere. I got an opportunity to interact with so many universities, especially in Tamil Nadu colleges, engineering colleges, and arts and science colleges. But whenever I talk to them, what are they trying to teach? What are they trying to teach these children, and what they understand is completely different. Once they come out of the education system and when they start, you know, when they start go for a job, this is going to be a big challenge for India upcoming days. We're talking about emergency situation now. Okay, let's innovation, technology, everything is fine. The manpower is there. So nobody talks about that. The manpower, how we are not going, how we are wasting that manpower. There is somewhere, there's complete concept of, you know, learning and working and the skilling. This needs to be taught. The skill management is nowhere in Indian universities taught. Skill is complete skill. What is skill? Nobody understands that. It's not about going to college and learning something and coming out of that. When the moment you come out of the college, what skill you got, that is what the industry is going to pay. What skill is skill you got, that is what the government of India is pay. We produce lakhs and lakhs of, you know, engineers every year, but nobody has got any skill. We call it as a mechanical engineer or any engineer, but nobody knows what it is. But this is very important. We cannot depend on government to come up with ideas. We have got so many engineers already working on the field. They're already employed. And some of our friends are already heading the big organizations, MDs and CEOs. They can come forward and collaborate with these universities and suggest them, okay, whatever you are teaching is fine, but this is what is a skill set, what we need. If you teach this skill set to the students, they can be productive in our industry. That is what is missing. See, I see a sad situation here. 80%, you would say 80% of the students are not going to the job. It's not getting the job. There is a gap between, we have got enormous job opportunity, but we don't get right skilled people. That gap only will be filled if you take our engineers. IEA can come up with a mission mode. IEA can come up with an idea and you know, so many people come together. And you can talk to these engineering colleges and tell them, okay, these are the skills are needed to reshape our country. If you produce more skilled engineers, I think we can solve all, whatever the problem it may come, we can solve. Thank you so much.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. What you said rightly, yeah. I think the skill mode has to be developed. I think definitely government is also working. Can we ask our Dr. P.S. Kumar? So I think you already said about, mentioned about the value of production, the scaling up and the quality concern. So the challenges like readily waited for the young engineer. What do you wanted to say then?
Yes, please. And thank you, Gokul. So it was very nice to interact with a lot of learned people and I would like to stress upon only 2-3 points. First point is, as correctly told by Mr. Kalirajan of L&T, we are lacking mainly on our efficiency and the effectiveness. What's the difference between efficiency and the effectiveness? If you see efficiency is doing things consistently, whereas effectiveness is doing right things. See, if you think that if your organization, you are 75% efficient and seven people process your order, it means collecting an order to dispatch the item to the customer, there are seven people are involved. That means order acceptance and managing director approval, purchase order releasing for the raw materials, processing the purchased raw materials into the finished product, quality and inspection, and checking, and then sending it to the. If your organization efficiency is 75%, and if whole organization works on 75%, we wrongly assume that our organization is total efficiency 75%. It is only 13%. If 1% efficiency is 75%, he gets 100 rupees and gives 25% he losses and gives only balance 75 rupees to the next person. And he, because of his inefficiency, he removes 25% of 75% and gives only balance amount. Finally, it goes, if your organization efficiency, if you think that is 75%, actually seven people process the order, your organization efficiency is only 13%. Even if you take 95% is your organization efficiency, your overall organization efficiency is only 70%. I had been to China many times. I have interacted. I bought millions worth of items from Chinese. Their efficiency is much ahead. They are at least 95% in every factory. That means minimum 70% overall efficiency. Whereas in India, we are around 90% efficiency. Overall efficiency of our organization, individual organization 90%, overall 90 into 0.7 into 0.7 like that, if you put it, it will be only 28% efficiency of our overall organization. So we have to improve our efficiency and effectiveness. So that is the first and foremost thing to handle the situation, to be more cost competitive. That's what we are not competitive. Producing a product or manufacturing a product is not going to be, it's going to be the same whether you are producing it in India or whether you are producing it in China. But how efficiently you are producing it makes a difference. Okay. And the second thing what APR has told, sustainable development visualizes the future. 100% I agree, because we are very short-sighted. We are not thinking or we are not forecasting what is likely to happen and then work for it. Like why we are facing the situation, suddenly we are coming out and the huge opportunity is coming from across the globe. And just because we have not moved to Industry 4.0 environment, international companies will not come and place order on us. Whereas countries like Malaysia, countries like Vietnam are already ahead of us in Industry 4.0. So the potential business moving from China to India is less compared to China to Malaysia, China to Vietnam. So that is the second point. So we need to visualize at least now, and we start looking out what is the current development taking across the world. Because by going with Industry 4.0, we are able to reduce your initial investment itself by 30%. And increase your productivity by 40% and reduce your product cost by minimum 35%, reduce your manpower by 40%. We have done a lot of study on it and it is possible, because I can give a small example, but it may take, how much time it will available, Gokul?
Yes, it's almost over. I think we can go for a question and answer now.
Okay, then I will not give the talk. I will conclude my talk with the third point. And that's the last point, like what Mr. Sheikh Dawood has told, skill management. Okay, many people don't understand what is the skill and what is the quality. Quality has to be built up. Earlier people thought that skill has to be by practice. Now skills can be taught. So the skill development has to take place. And without the skills, efficiency is by practicing only. Effectiveness is by practicing only. So if the skill development is very, very critical. So summing up all three points which I told you is improve your efficiency and effectiveness. Second is increase our productivity by improving our skill development. And third one is develop ourselves for the international market, like new technologies like Industry 4.0, so that when the new opportunity comes, we can make use of that opportunity and grab the business rather than allowing it to go to our friends at Vietnam and Malaysia and Thailand, other countries. Thank you very much for the opportunity given, Gokul. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir. I think we have come to the end of the session. Almost 7:33, so 3 minutes ahead. So I think now we have almost 40 attendees are there in our Zoom meeting. So it's open up for the QA session. So any members wanted to ask any kind of a question, I think few members have given the chat also. So they can able to put up the questions to the speakers, as well as we have our Vice President, World Engineering Federation Organization and Chairman, IEA. So anybody can pick up the question and they can answer.
Sir, one more question, sir, from RNSM, from Madurai.
Yes, sir.
Sir, excuse me, sir, can you tell your name and then tell about your question?
Yeah, name from which place?
Narayanasamy. Narayanasamy. Honorary Secretary from Madurai Local Center. Madurai Local Center.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Please go ahead, sir.
Sir, what about the test equipment in India? See, if you go any field, electronic field, electrical field, or aerospace field, the test equipment we are getting from the foreign countries only, not manufacturing from India. You go for anything, even broadcasting also, everywhere, the test equipment. Now, we are very, very lagging about the test equipment, particularly COVID-19. We are very lagging at the test equipment we are importing from the China. What about our technology from India? Why not we are manufacturing test equipment?
Yes, sir. Hello.
Yeah. Hello. Hello, sir.
Gokul? Mr. Narayan Swami, see, it's not like that. No, we have a production capacity.
He's asking about the test and measuring equipment.
That is what I'm speaking about that one day.
Sir, one minute, sir. Sir, I'm not talking about the manufacturing equipment. Whatever the equipment we are manufacturing,
test and measuring,
we should have the test equipment.
Calibration,
testing,
test and calibration.
Progressive, we should have it. We are not having. Even in scan center also, you go there, we scan machines. And even our Doordarshan and All India, I'm from All India Doordarshan. Mm. Even there also, the testing equipments are imported from foreign countries like Japan, China, or various countries only. We are not manufacturing. Simple oscilloscope. That oscilloscope itself, we are importing from China.
Narayan Swami, let me, given an opportunity, I would like to explain. My name is Mani Vannan, and I am from the medical equipment industry. We are in the ventilators, very much relevant in the COVID market, and I had experience in working in China as a product developer for more than about 15 years. Okay, so coming back to the point, the test and measuring equipments are available in India. Very much available. If you go to Fluke, if you want to have a ventilator, the Fluke is having ventilators. Fluke has got a leakage thing. If you want to make a ECG machine, if you want to have a calibration equipment for a CT, MRI, they have everything. The problem with the test and measuring equipments is that you have to get it calibrated frequently with respect to another calibrating equipment from abroad. So these companies are doing it. In fact, if you take the Anna University Product Development Center in Guindy, they have a test and measuring equipment and calibration equipment for the entire medical equipment.
Sorry for the disturbance, sir. Sir, I know that the testing equipments are available. Whatever, these are all imported there. What I say, why not we manufacture in India? Why not? Whether we are not having the production capability or machines?
It depends upon the demand. Right now, if you take India, there are not many medical equipment manufacturers. So if you buy the calibration equipment, where is going to be the buyers for it? So that is the real catch. Even if you take a country like China, where they are manufacturing a lot of medical equipment, they don't produce the test and calibration equipment. Most of the equipments are imported from Europe and the US.
That is the condition, sir. That is the economic growth conditions. If India is manufacturing less than the cheap of that our China or some other countries, we also can, what is called, we can do the business of that. Why not we make...
Will you make the car or will you make produce the car calibration equipment? So if the cars are going to be more in number, then car calibration equipments can be manufactured in India. So right now, we are not in a big way, even in, there are only about 3-4 ventilator manufacturing companies. And once you take the Indian ventilator companies to the hospitals, they generally say, oh, this is made in India. We don't need it. We would like to have an importer. That's what every doctor does. So people started looking at the local manufacturing, basically because you cannot import it from the Europe, you cannot import it from the US.
Sir, you are talking about the only particular. Sorry, just one minute, sir. You are talking only particular. I am not talking about the particular field.
COVID.
Yeah, we understand. We will open up some more question session for others. I think this is all like what we need so much of improvement in our country. That is what COVID has put a hold for 21 days, and it has made us to think a lot. And definitely, I think the government is also going to take promising actions in order to bring out all these problems for the solution. I think we will address it like in a later way also, sir. I think our chairman is also witnessing. We can have a separate session. Also.
Thank you.
So can we have second questions from anybody else? Like we can have like, we can restrict to 5 questions. So then we can able to conclude this session.
Hello. Hello. Are you hearing me, sir?
Yeah. We are.
I am Muthukrishnan from Chennai. I am Muthukrishnan from Chennai, working in plastic industries. Mr. Kumar knows me.
Yes, sir.
Actually, I want to make 2 points here very importantly. Engineering students, yes, of course, we are having a skilled engineers. The problem is lack of guidance on manufacturing segment of the job opportunities for them. Because every engineers are looking at software side. So they are not aware. See, if you go like a southern part of Tamil Nadu, there are good engineers are there. I used to visit a lot of engineering college to train the people and give them some presentation and all. So we need to train the people from the third year onwards related to the industry's requirement and select the people from the interested field. Like some people, students may interested in design, some students may interested in maintenance, some may in productions, some may in sales. So the engineering colleges has to start the training from third year onwards on this particular area. For that, Indian Engineers Association has to support. We have to debut our team by dividing the district-wise or zonal-wise, send our members to give the training and requirement once in a month in a rotational manner. So that will give a lot of impact to the students. And we can develop the skills to the engineers and we can open up them like all the latest technology to them. Because they are studying only the subjects. They are not understanding the requirement of industries. After the engineering, they are blank when they're coming to the industries. This is what I want to highlight on this point. I think somebody is there in this group who is advisor to the health ministry also. They can take it up this point and all the honorable members, I request these points.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, Muthukrishnan, sir. Definitely, I think we will take it up. I think Velraj, sir, wanted to share some idea. Who is a professor from Anna University, also like an eminent engineer of IEA Tamil Nadu. Sir, you can share it, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you for the opportunity, Gogul. Yes, I would like to share a few points. This IEA has been doing for long years about various disciplines-wise, engineering discipline-wise, that is civil, mechanical, chemical. In that aspects, we have been focusing. But now the future requirement is based on the multidisciplinary effort. So our focus should be on, for me, to my understanding, it should be on some 5 or 6 areas. First area requirement is on health, then agriculture, energy, environment, material and manufacturing, and new technology. So these are the areas. New technology may be on all these 5 areas: health, agriculture, energy, environment, and this material and manufacturing. In addition, new technology. So our focus of all the engineers should be on these areas. Totally, our engineers are not contributing on the health sector. But there is a major requirement on bio engineering. We are very strong in traditional medicines, but still we are not able to make it useful for this international community because lack of how to, even I am a professor, I am not able to make some of my invention to the real that is the real society, that is real industrial requirements. That conducive atmosphere is still missing. So these are the five areas where how to make products, how to make innovation into product formulation. These things, if EA's focus is instead of engineering separate discipline, this type of what is functional wise, if we start working, then that will be good outcome will make turn. Then this another, as I in the middle I told you that conducive atmosphere for the product development, that is research translation into innovative products, the individual cannot do. A system has to be created, but that system government is not able to do it. The organization like IEA can think of that and how to make, how to create a innovative, that is innovative ecosystem, converting this product, this research innovation into product and product into commercialization stage, how to do it, and in the ecosystem has to be created. These things are missing. Presently, somebody, Mr. Amar Prasad, he told that our products are very good. We know that our the traditional medicines are very good, but we cannot tell this to the international community that we have a medicine for all these things. We are not, none of the medical doctors also cannot tell, traditional doctors also cannot tell. That is, this Ayurvedic doctors also, they are not able to speak to the international community that we can make something out of that. So these things, some confidence has to be created by making some ecosystem. That is what I want to convey. Yes. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Gokul, I want to just just tell him that. So see, let me tell you, what is his name? I didn't get a...
Velraj.
Mr. Velraj ji, see, I think after a lot of discussion, I think the Prime Minister has already set up a Ministry of Ayush. Ayush is a separate ministry, is established, and we are working very closely with all these alternative medicine people like Ayurveda, Homeopathy, Yunani, Siddha. We are very closely working with, and in fact, white paper has been already produced to the World Fraternity that what need to be done from Ministry of Ayush to build a immunity. For in fact, they haven't come out with any vaccine. They just said that the simple thing is just build your immunity. So in that, I have already told, golden milk is something which builds your immunity, and another one thing they have told is take lot of steam. This steam is another thing which can loosen up all your congested areas in lungs somewhere. So steam with pudina, mint leaves, it is already done. But only thing is that I think whatever we say, the World Fraternity is not going to accept Ayurveda as of now. And even in the future also, they have their own reservations. At least for India, I think we should be able to deliver it on time. For example, Kabasura Kudinir, which they make mandatory now, everyone is drinking it. So I think we are acting. But vaccine need to be produced by only allopathy people. That is how the world is moving. And fortunately, I think in India, I think we have a natural immunity. So that has been built by our forefathers, and we are carrying it, and we should be able to give it to the future generation. The government is doing what the best possible ways, and nobody has predicted this kind of situation will happen. In spite of that, you can see what's happening in USA, what's happening in Spain, what's happening in Italy. But in India, we are still in stage two. That I think we have to appreciate the government. You have anything to be discussed with the group of ministers every 2 days, let me put to all of the speakers and participants. Can you hear me? Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. So every 2 days there is a meeting happens in the ministry. It's a group of ministers meeting. You could have seen it in TV. All ministers will sit and discuss under the chairmanship of our minister Harshavardhan ji. He is the health minister for the country. So if you have any ideas, please share it with me through Gokul. So I think we can take it to the GOM, and if they are ready, if they are interested, I think they can immediately work on it. And one more important thing I think we have to discuss. I forgot to tell. Madam Soumya Swaminathan, daughter of Mrs. Swaminathan from Research Foundation. She is with the World Health Organization. She has clearly told that data is going to play a very vital role. This is very clear. She says that it's not about the test, it's not about the vaccine, it's not about the medicine. It's about the data. So we have to collect the data. As of now, let me tell you, let me confine this to Tamil Nadu. And this is my personal statement that doesn't reflect the government or anybody's interest. I say that as of now, we don't have a technology or we don't have a platform to collect the data. See, let's imagine tomorrow we are going to do testing, rapid test kits for rapid testing for means 10 lakh people in Tamil Nadu. Mm-hmm. It's very tough, no? You don't have a data. Without data, how you are going to do the analytics?
Yes, so yes.
The present system is that, no? A doctor, a health worker will go to you, will come to your house. He will take the test and he will mark a note. For some disturbance.
Somebody is keeping a phone and the desktop nearby.
You can switch off all the people mic and allow Mr. Ramar Prasad Reddy to talk so that other people can hear.
So, yeah. Hello.
Yes, sir. You can go ahead, sir.
So basically, I think we have to just integrate. The data is going to be the very big vital factor in the entire scenario, my dear friends. And absolutely, I'm telling there is no technology available with government of Tamil Nadu. Let me tell you very bluntly, because they will accept this. Because, doing tests and getting positive or negative is something different. But we need data. That is very important, which will give a kind of whole picture how it's going to work, because data plays a vital role. I think even IEC has to think about it, creating a platform with all our young fellows. It's a very simple system. Data manipulate, data analytics is totally depends on the more you collect the data, the more you are going to get the solution. I think that is the missing factor, actually. It's not about the natural medicine is not taking to the world. And any inputs from this group can be passed to me with a small write-up. I think I can immediately put to the GOM.
I have an intervention here, Ahmad. Please. Your collection of data is... I am Sanjay Gadale calling from Hyderabad. I'm entering from Hyderabad. I've been hearing you out. There are a few, 4 or 5 questions which need to be actually allocated time. But before closing your particular topic, the story is that if you need to have data, you need to have a process of collecting the data. Unless you work on that properly, there is no point in just asking for the data. A lot of work is actually happening, and we need to address that first before we talk about processing data. There's no point in taking garbage and then processing garbage and coming out with garbage as output.
Let us first address the process
of collecting the data properly and ensuring that those correct data points are addressed. Before we talk about
name. I didn't get your name.
My name is Sanjay Gadale.
Mr. Sanjay.
All my point is.
Can I interrupt?
I think there are some questions from Gayatri and the rest of the people. Can we have them addressed, please?
Yes.
We can address your questions one-on-one, Amar. You can leave your email ID and your number. Gokul is aware of it. We can have a closer discussion on that.
Yeah.
Sure, Sanjay. No issues. I think, can we ask Professor Gayatri from Nasik? She wanted to ask some query. So, ma'am, are you there? Can you throw the question?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir?
Yes, ma'am. Go ahead.
Yeah. Sir, right now we have discussed the skill set required for industry. But being a teacher, we have to adhere to university curriculum and we have to go with university curriculum. So I'll request industry person, can you please share the exact required skill set from those engineering student so that we can work out, we can make them industry ready, and it will be both helpful for both for student, for faculty and for industry. Please, sir.
Yeah, Gayatri, this is Dr. P.S. Kumar here. There is a lot of new technology has come, like Dr. Velraj has already pointed out, the main gap between the factory produced, I call it like that specifically, because the engineering colleges are producing engineers who are not employable. The main reason is the technological requirement what industry is using and the technology what you are teaching in the colleges are a huge difference. I agree with you, Mrs. Gayatri, that because you have to follow the university curriculum, you need to follow that syllabus only. I am not saying like that. Like currently, if you are talking about mechanical engineering, if you are talking about something related to design, drawing, things like that, whatever the software platforms you are using and whatever the software platforms currently being used in the industry is much different. So you need to equip your student on that. We cannot blame the student or we cannot blame the faculty also, because the technological development is happening so fast. Like earlier, if you say the product lifecycle management is only for 15 years, 12 years. Now it is only 6 months, 1 year. Every technology, every platform, every software is getting upgraded or some other software is coming and changing over. It happens in across the sectors, mechanical, electrical, electronics, you take it, any subject, it comes like this. Second, giving to one more things like Mr. Dr. Velraj and Mr. Sarogopan told, very, very important thing is our people are not focusing on medical equipment. 72% of the products of medical products imported to India. It is not manufactured in India. The main problem is reliability. That's why people say that when we ask many of the doctors, oh, you are not buying a ventilator from India, like what Mr. Sarogopan Manivannan said, because if the ventilator fails, the patient dies. So the reliability is more important. To get that reliability, you need to have the quality standards. To get that quality standard, you have to equip yourself on manufacturing standards. For getting that manufacturing standards, you have to gear up a lot and work on it. But for that, what happens is your profitability, you are not able to get the order for the investment what you are making because of your inefficiency, because of our own ineffectiveness. So we have to improve our efficiency and we have to be cost competitive. Till we are being cost competitive and increase our efficiency to the international players, we may not be able to get the business even moving out of China itself. Forget about holding it, going to Vietnam, and China is not going to sit across and watch the entire business moving out of China to go to other countries. They will do everything because they already got the benefit of all the exports benefits and all the costs they might have recovered. So it is very easy for them to reduce their price. So you have to improve our efficiency. You have to gear up to the international standard. That is what Mr. Bala and Gokul has told. We have to move into the industry 4.0 environment.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. I think we are almost there for 90 minutes at this session. And definitely, I think I should thank all the speakers. Also, the attendees who could able to spend their valuable time. Definitely, I think we have thrown so many topics. And that is going to come in like alternative day, some kind of a session, which we can able to make it up. I think we will circulate the email ID IEATamilnadu@gmail.com. So further questions can be written to the mail ID to whom you wanted. We will able to circulate and we will answer up. Definitely, I think this platform, we are going to make it up furthermore. The government of Tamil Nadu already announced another 15 days lockdown. So maybe with the permission of chairman and our vice president, our past president also, we can continue this kind of session every alternative day, each and every topic, and then we can able to make a kind of a document, and our Dr. Amaprasad Reddy sir is there, Daud sir is there. I think we can able to make a document and we can able to write it down to the government also where they are required, and we will do that. And finally, I think I can ask our chairman and our Gunaraja sir to address for a few words as a concluding remarks.
Sir,
Gunaraja, sir, you can unmute it, sir. You can remove the mute. Yes, sir.
Yeah, everybody here.
Yes, sir.
It is very nice that we have a lot of participants from apart from the speakers who have raised very valid questions. And all our speakers are able to respond to it. And as Gokul said, we can take up different topics, even the 5G. 5G is a talk of the global talk now. that even that topic can be taken for the future and can be discussed. Even WHO is planning to have a meeting in the 5G. We can, before that, we can, in the IE level, we can take up this topic and discuss in the future.
Sure, sir. Thank you so much. I think some of our people wanted about the topic. I think whatever topic we sent today, I think manufacturing of sanitizer and disinfectant, everything, I think we are going to come it up with a different session. So we will plan it up and we will have a separate, like a few specialized system engineers or speakers to address this issue. Can we ask our Ramadas sir to give some concluding remarks? And also thank our IEA Tamil Nadu State Center to giving this opportunity for all of you.
Thanks, Gogul. I think this kind of meeting is first time we are did in the on behalf of Institution of Engineers Tamil Nadu State Center. The entire meeting backbone is Mr. Balamurugan is committee member, and then Gokul and B. Ramesh, secretary. They are the backbone of entire this kind of. Thanks one and all, everybody participate in that particular event. Thank you one and all.
Yes, sir. Balamurugan is there.
Yes, Gokul, I am there. Thank
I think
you so
can
much
give
for
our vote of thanks and you can close this session.
Thank you so much for the participant, and it was a wonderful session with all the discussions, but some of the point has been missed out, but still that would be catered at a later time because it was planned for only 1 hour. As it has crossed more than 1 hour, so we would collect all the informations as a Q&A, as you said, IEATamilNadu@gmail.com. So people can freely post their questions so that it would be addressed in the forthcoming session, sir. So I'm thankful to past president, chairman, and chairman secretary of Tiruvallur Local Center, and all the committee members, as well as the people who are in the background to coordinate each and every event of this, every moment of this session. And thank you so much for the participants who were very vital and very patiently listening to the information. But the session was planned only for 1 hour, so that you get an opportunity with a forthcoming session, sir. I am very thankful to the speakers, especially Amar Prasad Reddy, sir. So he was very busy with his schedule, but he has given his overwhelming response by posting all the information and interacting with the participants. And sir, P.S. Kumar, sir, so regarding the production and other experience of China and other things, and I will also thankful to all the participants, sir. Thank you so much for your time. So we can close the session, Gokul. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes, Balamurugan. So thank you so much for all our partners also. Our NYC, EWB Chennai, and TVLC, the chairman and secretary, Dr. Ramesh, sir. And Agatiam also. So I think we will connect it soon with all our another session with our permission of our chairman. So thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
Well done, Gokul. Keep it up.
Thank you, Sandeep. Bala, you can close it.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.